Unmute. All right, now let's do a quick audio test. 1, 2, I'm in the yellow.
Whoa, what color am I in?
You're...
I was very quiet and very loud during Slightly Something Else today.
There you go.
So.
You're in the red, and so I'm going to just turn you down a little bit. Which one are you coming through? Hold on, you're coming through this one. All right, how about now?
Hello, everyone. Welcome back. I'm speaking again. How do I sound?
Now you sound about where I sound. So we're good to go. Hey, everybody. There's a couple things that we need to do. One, I need to open Steam. I'm running late, and you know that happens. I'm gonna
Minor technicality.
I'm gonna open Steam. We need to add another explosion to the overlay, so I just figure we'll do that on stream while I wait for the game to open.
Heck yeah!
And I just need to say, hey everybody, thanks for joining us today on Explosions Only Stream. We're gonna get close today. We might finish off the game today.
Yeah.
But it's unlikely because of Malekith. So we'll see.
Yeah. So this is episode 6, I believe. We left off last time, Jack, in a pretty easy fashion, dispersed with the Godskin duo.
That's right.
Godskin duo. Who I had said were a big pain in the ass for me and were very little pains in the ass for a man like Hank Meatfree.
Absolutely. Meat fiction. Yes. Truth in meat fiction.
The legends of Hank Meat Freedom are called Hank Meat Fiction, according to Geldon. I like it. Also, and Beast Marsh with a $5 donation, a pre-show $5 donation. Thank you so much, pal. Says some money for showing us the Snowfield shortcut last stream that I was finally able to figure out. And because of that, I beat the fire giant last night. Hell yeah. He is a big old pain in the ass for most people's playthroughs. So
absolutely.
And as you can see, in honor of our 6th episode and in honor of you beating the fire giant, we just got more fires. It's so big.
It's so... If we go this... Oh, no, that's not what I want to do. Hold on.
It's starting to feel like the HUD in a mech game, like where it's like almost like your window of view is getting smaller and smaller because there's just explosions everywhere.
There we go. We'll just add this one like here. There we go. Perfect. There we go. Well, to me, the explosions are a way to make sure that I wrap this up soon, because I can lollygag. Like, we can go off and do other things in Elden Ring. I could just play Elden Ring, you know, just whatever, explosions. But I figure if we add an explosion every single stream, eventually no one will be able to watch the stream. And
this
so
is true.
This is my own way to play Elden Ring to make sure that we don't go over. So
yeah,
don't go over time.
I saw someone the other day, I don't know if they were recommending it for you or just talking about it in general, but we're talking about a completely HUDless run of the game, which so there's no rules to how you play, but you have no information at your disposal during combat, which seems like that can be tricky. You have no idea how close to death you are, how close to death they are, how many healing items you have left.
I'd be very interested in that. I don't know if I would enjoy that necessarily, but I would be very interested in that. That's a neat idea, and I really like it.
Yeah.
I really like it, whoever suggested that to us. Okay, can
I can't remember if it was on one of these videos or another video I was watching or during one of my nightmares I was talking about earlier. Maybe during my nightmares. I didn't study for a test. I'm not wearing any pants, but I also get suggestions for various Elden Ring challenges.
Who needs pants? One.
Pants are overrated. I mean, society kind of deems us like necessary for pants because you can't be like hanging brain out at a public market.
That's true. By the way, here's a little preview. As we were talking about other possible runs, I hit continue, not remembering that I was doing some practice runs.
Okay.
So here's a little practice run that I was working on that I'm going to call Sticks and Stones. In which you are only allowed to use items with stick names or stone names.
Oh, interesting. Okay.
And so there's like one wand that is like, look, it's a branch. It's a stick.
That's a stick.
There's two spells that you can use. And
that have rocks and stuff in them?
Well, there's two spells that the Briar spell, this guy right here. Oh no! A pebble, pebbles.
Pebble
spell.
Pew. Yeah.
But then there's also the Briars of Sin, which is this, which is an awesome spell. And then of course there is the Bestial Sling, which throws stones.
Oh, very cool.
So I was testing that out to see like if it was cool or not. The only issue is eventually you just use Be Still Sting, Sling, and it's the best weapon ever. And that's all you end up using is Be Still Sting, Sling.
Yeah, yeah. So you kind of fall into a pattern.
Yeah, and so it's like I'm not utilizing the sticks as much as I would like to. So we are going to quit this game and go back to Hank Meat Freedom. So yeah, I was like getting the initial, because the first weapon that you are able to get is Briars of Sin, and you need the stick in able to do that. And so farming for that stick took me like 3 hours.
Is that a purchase? Like, do you purchase the stick?
No, it's a rare. It is a 2% drop from only 10 enemies late game.
That's a pain in the ass.
And so you have to like make them run into other enemies that will kill them.
Oh my god.
All right, where's Hank? There's Hank Mead Freedom. There we go. But once you get it, it's amazing, and it's a faith scaling staff.
Mm-hmm.
So it's pretty sick. Oh yeah, okay.
You get
so
pretty beefy, yeah.
Here's Hank Meat Freedom. Something I wanted to check is I think that if you remember last time, we thought, and we it might be oh no,
oh yeah, we left confused about a quest line in Volcano Manor, correct?
Because this happy little fella over here, if you go to Volcano Manor, he stays here. I didn't talk to him at the Round Table Hold, so he never left the Round Table Hold, so he's right here.
Gotcha. That's just glossed right over him. Is that Dialos? Is that who that is?
That is Dialos. You might be surprised to learn Aeonia to ask. It's on Mount Gelmir. That's where they hide. Just you wait. You'll rue the tale of how. Okay, so now we've talked to him. So now we go back to Volcano Manor, because we need to do this in order to do the Jar Baron quest, which gets us the medallion that ups our jar potency.
Gotcha. Pure Pyro says, Marty and Jack, did you manage to find the secret of Volcano Manor, Illusionary Wall, without a guide? I'm not sure which secret you're talking about. I mean, there was that one wall in Volcano Manor that, remember, you had to hit like a million times for it to open? Well, I definitely didn't do that. I saw the videos of that and I thought that was funny, but like,
no, there's.
It's funny that one wall had like 1,000 HP or whatever.
There's this wall that you have to go into in order to get to the secret of Volcano Manor. And yeah, like even without, like obviously everybody leaves a message over here, but even without the messages over here, there's a dead body right next to it.
Yeah.
And it had a crooked painting on the wall.
I also just hit everything that kind of looks like
100%. 100%. And it's like,
oh yeah, Pretty Power says this one. Yeah, I did actually. I did manage to. Yeah. I did. I think I did everything without a guide in this game, which I don't know how that worked.
Like, heads up, some shorthand for Dark Souls games in general, but Elden Ring specifically. If they want you to notice something, they will put an item seemingly in a random place. If you just find an item in a random place, take a look around. There's probably something over there that you should notice.
Yeah.
All right, so now he's over here. Okay, we're comrades in arms. Alright, yep, so we gotta exhaust his dialogue. Great.
Okay.
Great, alright.
Okay, please stop talking, Dialos. Shut it, Dialos.
The House of Hazel's Stolen Blood. Okay, great. So then we'll go rest at the table site of grace, which is great. Nope, not the... There's not a table site of grace. There's just a site of grace. The FromSoft guides the players with shiny treasures in the dark. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. That's how they... one of the early complaints was that people weren't finding Bach, the seamster who was hidden in a bush.
Yeah.
And so, like, literally all they did was put a one of those stupid red leaves that no one ever uses, like, close enough. So people would, there's a shiny thing, so they could hear him.
Yeah, coming. Yeah. You get close and he's shouting at you.
Oh, where'd my friend go?
Rain.
Okay, so I exhausted his dialogue there. Where'd my friend go? Is he in Jarburg already?
Did he already bounce?
He might have. I'm trying to remember how many NPCs we beat last time. And it might have been... Oh, no, here he is. Now he's sad. Okay, now he's sad.
I'm terribly sorry I haven't achieved, even though I'm still yet to... Perhaps I am. No, it's worse. What an easy mark.
There he is. Now he's like, I'm an idiot. I'm a big dummy. I suck at killing things. Oh, I'm just the worst. Yeah.
Okay. I take weird poo. My poos are weird. I take weird ones.
Like, for some reason, it comes out and it's curved. I don't understand how that happens.
Doesn't make sense. I have a very sensible diet. I don't know why this is done to me.
It should come out straight, but it curves. It curves.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it seems to curve. He's like, the weird thing is, I've looked at it. It curves after it comes out.
That doesn't make any sense.
That doesn't make any sense. It comes out straight, curves at it. Secondly, how do you look at it? And like, you don't have cameras. You're an Elden Ring.
You don't have cameras. You're an Elden Ring.
Okay, so now I believe I have to go kill his brother, Juno Haslow. So we're going to go do that real quick.
Haslow. Magamaga says, just tuned in, might have missed the rule set for the challenge. Anyone have a TLDR version? Jack, you want to just give a TLDR for our explosions rules?
It's just as simple as that. You have to think of Hank Meat Freedom, who is the character I'm playing, as an 80s action star. So we are only allowed to do damage via explosions. Not magical explosions, just explosions. Mm-hmm. And so I can use fire pots, volcano pots, and explosive bolts. That's it. I can use, they have like the explosive stones, like those rocks that explode, but mm-hmm. they do so little damage, I end up not using them. I have them around just in case, like, I run out of ammunition and, you know, need a little boost.
Yeah.
But so far...
And in terms of summons, the mimic tier has been our best friend because we consider him to be our stunt double.
Correct. So we have the mimic tier, who also can only hurt via explosions, obviously. Mm-hmm. Oh, crap. I can't craft. I shouldn't need to because this is going to be jar cannon. It's going to be real jar cannon-y. We have the soul jars of fortune, but they kind of suck.
Compared to the mimic tier, they're underwhelming. Same thing with that one physic that allows us to explode.
Yeah.
Neat in theory, but not in execution. Dobby Sock asks, have we done any PvP? I don't believe so.
No.
I mean, not with this character. Have you done PvP in your own time?
No, you know what? Characters? I don't. I really don't.
I've never been a big PvP person in any From games, if I'm being honest.
Right. That's a whole, like, PvP is, in my mind, an entirely different game.
Yeah.
And it's just not anything I'm interested in. Like, the meta builds, the people who, like, know the, like, exact way. It's like chess.
Yeah, yeah.
Where...
Yeah, I find it super, like, it's really interesting for me to, like, watch videos on it and stuff, but it's never anything, like, I want to put the time or effort into.
Right. Yeah, I think like chess is a really good way to put it.
Yeah.
Or interesting. It is incredibly interesting, but it's too much. It's too much for my dumb brain.
Yeah. It's so much like chess that a lot of people consider the Queen's Gambit to be a Souls-like.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
All right, so here's how NPC works, which is we try to get our cannon ready, get them close, and hit them and knock them over, run away. Run, because we have to run far enough away where we have time to load the dang cannon, which is honestly the biggest pain in the ass.
We pretty much have to, it's like, wait till we see the light of their eyes or else swift enemy like this will dodge.
Like he just did.
Yeah. Yeah, it's almost like the distance and timing of using your gun in Bloodborne for viscerals.
Yes.
Like, you need to be, like, brave to stagger enemies.
Oof. going to be tough. Come on. Oh, fuck you. He hit me from the other side of a bush that I didn't think he could hit me from.
Rude.
You know what? I'm just going to say that. Rude.
You know, rude little bush. Rude bush boy.
He's a. You know what? He's kind of a rude bush boy if you think about it.
Yeah.
Yeah, and his whip can cancel out my attack, so I need to hit him.
Yeah. Ugh.
But I also need to wait until he reels back, or I won't hit him. So it is a wicked timing.
Judge Lucas says, "Does this guy respawn? Didn't Jack beat him last time? I don't think we fought this guy last time.
We fought the other two Volcano Manor.
Yeah."
Contracts. We did not fight him. So this is the last one that we need to fight in order to progress the other guy's thing. Okay, one more shot and I should be able to do it. Just gotta find that right timing.
Oh, fuck. Also, you guys are kind of getting a little you're getting a little taste of a HUDless run because that explosion is like covering up all of our health and stamina and stuff, so that kind of works.
Ah, fuck. I was so close.
And that's a bummer.
As everyone just saw, like, even while he was, like, reeling back, he moved just enough to where my bolt was able to miss him.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, it's just that much sometimes. All right, here we go. HUD is just, yes, my HUD is nothing but explosions. All right. Flame grant me strength. Get the cannon ready. Explode. Reload.
Explode.
There we go. Like, I feel like if I hit get cannon ready right out of a roll, it gets ready faster. I don't know if
faster. Yeah, it might be one of those like psychological things where it's like I'm always like, Link definitely moves faster if you roll and not great time. And part of me is like, I don't know if he does, but I just do it anyways.
Right. Am I fat rolling? No, I'm not fat rolling. It felt like a moment like I was fat rolling. Oh no, nope. Oh fuck. Yep, I knew it. The stupid, like, get cannon ready animation takes so long. Oh, fuck.
Oh, yeah, fart phase. Not a dumb question at all. Yeah, HUD means all the information displayed on screen. So we wouldn't see, you know, the items we have equipped and everything in the lower left-hand corner. Right. We wouldn't see our health or you know, stamina or anything like that in the upper left-hand corner. We wouldn't see our runes in the bottom right. We wouldn't have any of the knowledge of if we're currently suffering from poison or anything like that.
Mm-hmm. HUD is a lovely acronym for heads up display.
Mm-hmm. CHUD is an acronym for cannibalistic humanoid underdwellings.
Underground. Is it underdwellings or is it underground dwellers?
Ooh, maybe that's like a. Your part of the state calls it what? It's like a soda and pop thing, or like a like bubbler and a water fountain.
Bubbler and water fountain. Yes. But agreed. Not a dumb question at all. Because HUD is one of those things that gets used a lot, and you know, you're just like, oh, that's all the crap on screen.
yeah. So yeah, in that kind of a mode, you'd still be able to, you know, you'd open your menu, do everything in your menus and everything. That's fine. But it's just obviously in combat, you'd be at the mercy.
Yeah. I also figured out what my huge problem here is I keep rolling, and the reason I died last time is because I ran into the invisible wall.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, like, I need so much space to get my stupid cannon ready.
Yeah.
Fuck, I missed it.
Alexandra says it's only bubbler, and I refuse to hear anything else. Listen, I grew up in a bubbler zone, and as an adult, I think bubbler's weird, but I love it.
I mean, it doesn't bubble. I get that. But yeah, I'm a bubbler.
No. Yeah.
Stop it. Let me blow you up.
Let me blow you up.
Oh, come on. Oh, fuck you. I hit you. Were standing still. Now you're going to heal. You're not going to heal? Oh, now you heal, you dingus. There.
Bannonborm says, is that one of those weird Midwestern things? It is definitely... I know it's a big Wisconsin thing, Bubbler. I don't know if it's...
Bubbler's not even a big Wisconsin thing. It's a big, like, specific part of Wisconsin. you go to other places in Wisconsin, and they do not know what a bubbler is. Like,
yeah,
that don't bubble. They also are Southern, apparently.
That dog don't bubble.
That dog don't bubble.
Pure Pyro says, there are bad HUDs and then there are good HUDs. A game like Horizon Zero Dawn had too many things on screen for my liking. Yeah, I feel like HUDs are, there's like a fine art to the HUD. Yahtzee and I were talking about that with the old shooters earlier today. I like that a lot of those Sony first party games have customizable HUDs. Like, you can choose what information you want to display and what you don't want to display. But yeah, by default, a lot of those games like Horizon and stuff like that are sort of like, it feels like just vomiting information on you.
Yes. So now here's a big problem. I've now lost this fight so many times, I'm running out of bolts. I'm running out of large bolts. This guy sucks.
Yeah, so every time we use a bolt... it is costing us money.
Yes.
And so if we win a fight, that's a good thing because we get some of those runes back.
Yeah.
If we lose a fight, that is just money down the drain. That is, yes. that is like paying rent in an apartment. Never seeing that money again.
You're never ever seeing that money again.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, like, this isn't a fight that would be worth it normally.
Yeah.
You know, he's not going to give us enough runes. Even if I beat him the first time, he wouldn't give us enough runes to cost the amount of ballista explosive bolts that I'm using.
Mm-hmm.
But we need it for the storyline. We need it for Jarberg. And it sucks. Because
sucks big time.
It sucks big time because my jars are too slow. It takes too long for me to throw my jars, and he will dodge them.
Yep.
So I can't use my jars, and my small explosive bolts won't knock him over. And so I could use them, but like, I would hit him, and then he would hit me. And so they are not worth it. There we go. There's one. And so the large bolts are kind of the only chance I have. Cookie is scratching at my door to get in, but I am working.
He's like, I want a HUD. I have thoughts on HUDs.
Cookie has a lot of thoughts on HUDs.
Yeah. Speaking of HUDs, Damian Glenn and Ben Wilkins both mentioned that Dead Space 1 and 2 have perfect HUDs because they are those kind of diegetic HUDs, where the HUD is like your character, so you can read your own health on Isaac's back.
Yeah, yeah.
When he opens up a menu, it is like a little hologram he opens up from his thing. That's always an example of a game that did something interesting with HUDs. Metroid Prime has a lot of the information displayed in your helmet. Even GoldenEye for N64 had the thing where you look at your watch, and that would be your, your menu.
That's right.
Yeah.
And, you know, the obviously, like, the less things that can get in your way, the better. I know, like, Ghost of Tsushima, like, definitely had a really good and fluid system as far as, like, getting things out of your way only when you really needed them. Even here, like, like, if you look at this now, there's no enemies nearby. So Elden Ring is like, guess what? You don't need your health or stamina bar right
now. Yeah, it's really smart.
We're getting rid of them.
Yeah.
Which is gorgeous and wonderful. Though, like, I would love, you know, the one thing that I always think about is Super Mario. Super Mario had one of the best health HUDs in gaming, bar none.
It was just physical. You could tell by looking at Mario.
Exactly.
You had one hit left or two hits left.
Exactly. If you think about Mario's size in hearts, that's all you need to know is, oh, he's big, he has two hits, he's little, he has one hit. Boom. That's his health. Like, being big didn't have any advantages except for, I guess, breaking bricks. But, like the system, which is like, oh, that's brilliant.
It'd be really funny if your character in this game just got a little bit smaller every time you got hit.
Right.
Like by your, when you have only a little bit of health, you're just like a, there's like a little guy running around. Damien Glenn says, I think about Mario's size a lot. Sure, nothing wrong with that sentence. Perfectly normal sentence. Nothing weird about it. George Lucas says, can't say I've paid much attention to HUDs. Interesting topic. Yeah, it's one of those things where, like a lot of things, if done well, you shouldn't notice it.
Yes. That's,
like, I feel like a lot of times music, sound design, editing, like, well, at least talking about movies, like these things, if done well, you should just not be thinking about them.
Which is often the shame, because then the best ones go unnoticed.
Absolutely, yeah.
This again. Whips are so hard to get the timing right with, as far as dodging goes. You know, like someone throws a big axe at you, you know when that axe is hitting, you know when to dodge.
Have you used whips in this game at all?
I have not. No, I rarely go dexterity.
Yeah.
Fuck. He was trying to drink out of his empty flask, and I thought I could.
You rascal!
I thought I could cheese him, but he got out of his animations. So I rarely use dexterity. How about yourself?
Yeah, same thing. I use them a little bit in a Bloodborne.
Okay.
Because I wanted to pretend I was playing Castlevania, and it worked. And it worked.
And
I
it
went
worked.
To Kingher's Castle. I had a whip, and I was like, I'm just a Belmont. Yeah, but not in this guy. I literally don't think I've ever equipped a whip with this guy. I also don't think, like you said, I don't think I had the dexterity for it. In real life as well, I wouldn't trust myself with a whip. I feel like I'd hurt myself.
Like in real life?
Oh, in real life, absolutely. Like people who snap a whip, I'd snap it back at me. I'd break my glasses. What am I going to do with all my glasses?
Okay. Got like one more hit. We can do this. Wait for the time. There we go. Ugh.
George Lucas says two whip build. That sounds insane. Just run. Who's running around the lands between with two whips?
That's what Juno Haslow does, and it's his bloody thorn, his freaking thorn whip, his pedal whip, Haslow's pedal whip here.
Fucking pedal whip. That's just a jump rope at that point. You just got a big jump rope, dude.
Yes, it is a deadly, deadly jump rope, and he's got two of them, and it sucks. It sucks to fight him. Because he builds up bleed so flippin' fast. All right, so now we have defeated him. Oh. Okay, so now we go back here. And this guy's
we should be able to invoice all the bolts we wasted.
Invoice them to Volcano Manor.
Yeah.
They had a job. Went a little over budget. We're going to need some extra stuff from you.
Listen, you got a whole mansion plus a big snake dude in the basement. Like, you clearly have enough money for this. Tulak the Barbarian over in chat says, power stancing whips rules in PvP. It's a little rough in PvE. That actually makes some bosses like Melania easier.
Because Millennia is weak against bleed. And so
shouldn't everything be weak against bleed? Doesn't everything, like, once you start bleeding?
Well, but some things are constructs, you see. Actually, things don't have blood, Marty. I apologize for doing that.
That is true. Like, you do fight like the deer ghost in like the dream realm.
Exactly.
What's that guy? Yeah, that
yeah,
dude
the
probably
deer ghost.
Is weak. Yeah.
That's his name. That's his official name.
Yeah.
The deer ghost. Oh, you know what else we need to do on this run is we need to see if I missed like buying a pot from one of the merchants, because we're missing a pot. Okay.
Oh, interesting. Do you know they hunt this village that
you should I hope I'll... Okay, yep. Those... Okay. Did the potentate come? Are you here?
Hello?
Where are you? God damn it, Haslow. or whatever your name is, whatever your goddamn name is. Where are you?
Wits. Cookie.
If Jack were to have come up with a challenge for Bloodborne, what would it be? For me personally, like, it would be whips. That's like,
yeah.
I have tried to do Bloodborne whip, like the cane whip, and yeah. I just cannot. All right, now where is he?
Worthy it is the run.
All right.
What was your favorite weapon in Bloodborne?
You know, the saw spear. Very early weapon.
The Beyblade?
The Beyblade, right?
Yeah.
That was the first, you know, my first playthrough was with the saw spear. Such a phenomenal weapon.
Yeah.
And I never felt the need to get anything else.
Yeah.
How about yourself?
No, that was a cool. I was, once I got Ludwig's Holy Blade, I liked having a little quick attack and then a big old greatsword.
Oh, that's a fun one.
Yeah.
All right. He's not there. And I already got Alexander's thing.
George Lucas says the saw cleaver, the starter weapon. That is probably like one of the more iconic weapons in the game. I think that's like what the dude on the cover has.
Yeah. And you know what? You can't go wrong with it. It's so badass.
Most of the weapons in that game are pretty cool.
Yeah.
Like, honestly.
Yeah. I don't think there's a bad weapon. The only thing is for me personally, I can't understand how the cane whip works.
Yeah. I was really bad with that as well. And a couple Billy Wilbo saying the cane in Bloodborne is great for crowd control.
My mind cannot figure out how to use it to hit literally anyone.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Okay, no problem.
Do you pity me?
Nope, I don't pity you. Okay, great. Yep, you're taking care of the things. That's great. Okay, great. So now Dialos is here in Jarburg, and he's going to stay and protect them because he's their new potentate. I hope nothing goes wrong.
What could possibly go wrong? Also, apologies to Jamon Toast. I've been pronouncing their game Hamon Toast because I thought we were like talking about like fancy hams, like jamon. Jamon.
Jamon.
It's just Jamon. This is Jamon.
You're being Sebastian the Crab. Jamon Toast. Okay, now what do I need to do? All right, Internet. He's here. What do I need to do now to make him... Do I need to go away? I did the Bloodborne DLC. I streamed the Bloodborne DLC a while ago.
Look at that.
Some great DLC right there.
That is. And some old-ass hunters.
Oh, that's beautiful.
They got some good whips in that DLC. A lot of whippy boys there.
A lot of weird weapons in that DLC. Which is, by the way, exactly what DLC
needs. Get outside your comfort zone. I hope this game, if it gets DLC, it's just got some weird shit in it.
Alert some poachers. Yeah, right? I don't know. Even though he's... Oh, okay. Here's what it is. I need to talk to the Jar Baron, not Dialos. And so then the Jar Baron is like, Dialos is all right, but I wish we had a big, strong person like you, Hank Mead Freedom. I hope nothing bad happens. And then we reload.
I wish we had a strong person like you who wears the body of one of our fallen ones on your head like a complete monster.
No. This was made for us by Uncle Alexander. Dialos, but I wish... Okay. Wish we had a big, smooth potentate like you. See, because this is a real problem, Jar Baron, is you want a smooth potentate, but you need a rough potentate. You need someone
smooth
with rough hands.
Smooth potentate.
I don't pity you. Fuck. All right. I'm just going to get out of here. We'll go say hi to the Turtle Pope. Which is, by the way, anyone who is super into this game like I am, do you follow Zuli the Witch on YouTube to see the incredible breakdowns that they do of, like... character design and like the hidden mechanics.
Absolutely wonderful.
They put out a video today talking about the cemetery shade.
Oh, cool.
And how, like, if you look closely at the character model, the shade itself, like the man looking thing, is probably not the real enemy. It's like a bug on their head, which is very From Software.
Oh, yeah, that is absolutely something they've done in almost all their games. Yeah. That's really neat.
But it's, like, really hidden in the mist and whatnot, and it's the bug that, like, shoots you with the wrap-up thing. But yeah. Also, the Cemetery Shade has a weapon that looks a lot like a Bloodborne trick weapon.
Interesting.
And so
that's pretty cool.
What that immediately made me think of is that's what I would love in some Elden Ring DLC.
Ooh.
Is some new weapons and specifically those trick weapons, because I fucking love trick weapons.
That'd be cool as hell.
Okay, here it is. So now now our editor-in-chief, Nicolandro, is happy because Jarberg is massacred.
He's only kind of happy because he only likes doing it by his hands.
Right.
He doesn't like it when fate intervenes.
Okay, so now they're all dead. Everyone's dead. Everyone's dead. Great. And so now...
And Eve with a €2 donation. Thank you so much. Eve says, thanks, guys, because Mondays always need explosions. Could not agree with you more. The tail, that's the kind
of one. Even if I'm... All right, yep. The tail, that's the kind of one. Even if great. I'm scared. Yeah. Good on you, Jarbaron. You chose a shitty potentate and got your entire village killed. Way to go.
You know, I had $1 for every time my jar friends chose the wrong potentate.
Yeah.
It'd be the $1, because this was the only time I've ever heard the word potentate uttered aloud.
This is not my doing. This is your fault, Jar Baron. You're the Jar Baron. Again, I do love this part, how, like, they show what the warrior jars do. It's just like, oh, yeah, I'm taking his guts and putting them in my jar to give me power.
Yeah.
That's how I get my power.
Pretty normal, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I saw that the first time. If you talk to Alexander after you beat Radahn.
Yeah.
He's just wandering around the battlefield, like stuffing people inside of him.
There's great warriors here. Oh, this is, I'm going to be so strong after I shove all these guts into me. Fuck yes. I love the warrior jars. They're my absolute favorite character in all of FromSoft games of all time because they shove guts into them. Yeah, it's beautiful.
It's kind of like, that's what I think Krang's big bodysuit. Are you familiar with Krang of
from
the Ninja Turtles?
Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, yeah.
Yes. So you know how Krang has that, like, big naked robot as a bodysuit?
Mm-hmm.
I like that the big naked robot just shoves brains in his stomach, and I feel like that's how you'd get smart. If you'd shove a bunch of brains in your stomach, you'd be a super smarty.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, that's right. Yeah. Okay, so now I gave Jar Baron Uncle Alexander's insides because I exploded Uncle Alexander. And then you reload the area one more time, and now, finally. Jar Baron left to go be his own warrior, and more importantly, left aside this happy fella. The companion jar. Here we go. We can get rid of the Fire Drake Talisman easily. The Companion Jar Talisman raises potency of throwing pots. Boom.
Heck yeah.
All right, so now we're going to do a quick sweep of some of the merchants to make sure I bought all the pots, because we are missing one pot still, and I don't know where it is. I thought we had them all, but we're missing some somewhere.
Jamon Toast 89 with a $2 donation.
Jamon
says, any plans for guest stars on Adventurers Nigh? Billy D. Williams, perhaps? I added that last part because I think it'd be great to have Billy D. Williams on Adventurers.
I would love to have Billy D. Williams. Yes, is the short answer. No plans. I personally would love to have guest stars. There is something we are working on, and I don't know if it's been announced yet, so I won't say anything. There is something we are working on to test the waters in that realm, is what
I
saying.
I think early access members who may have seen one of Nick's recent state of the content things might have seen some of that, but they were told to keep their lips sealed, otherwise Nick would, quote, go Jarberg on them, end quote.
I'm just going to town. Yeah. Okay, well then there you go. So we are working on some water testing, but yes, in general, I would love to have guests. I feel like we've talked about a few here and there, or I've talked about a few here and there with Nick, and to me it's really tricky. Because I never know how long the storylines are going to last. You don't have any jars, you idiot. And so I always feel weird where it's like, oh yeah, I'd love to have someone hang out with us for a couple hours, be in one episode. But then if everyone's having fun and it's like, oh, you know what? We actually need another episode to wrap this up satisfactorily. Yeah. Can you come back? And then it's scheduling into other bullshit.
Yeah. Yeah.
So like my time management is still bad enough where I feel weird about it.
Yeah. I don't even think it's your time management though. It's just the nature of communal storytelling like that. You don't know. You can't just be like, we'll only need you for an hour, because right. You don't know.
Right. You know what? I haven't. Ooh, okay. I think I found the merchant we need to go to. I have never been to this merchant yet. It is the nature of communal storytelling, but I feel like, you know, I could be very, very wrong, but on some of the actual play podcasts I listen to and some that I have guested on, mm-hmm. like, I feel like a more seasoned DM would kind of know when to ramp it up.
Yeah.
Like, hey, guess what? We got to move. And I yeah. always feel terrible with we got to move. Because yeah. we're all having fun and telling such a fun story together.
You're a Johnny Feels Good.
I am a Johnny
Feels Good. Like, you're not, you don't want to, yeah. You don't want to harsh your vibe.
Right.
You don't want to dampen your mellow.
Season 2 gets better every episode. Oh, we just recorded episode 12 Saturday. And holy moly, y'all, it is, it's an incredible amount of fun. Here's a pot. Oh, wait, that's a ritual pot. Well, I'll buy your ritual pot. Where the fuck is the last cracked pot? Have a safe journey. Where's the last cracked pot? Where's my cracked pot?
Where's the cracked pot?
Right? I guess, well, hold on. We got some more merchants we got to visit. We're just going to see if we can find this one. What Dungeons & Dragons podcast does Jack listen to? I haven't listened to them in a while just because I've been in full-blown Adventure Is Nigh mode, which I feel mm-hmm. terrible about because I love them all. NADPOD, not another D&D podcast, is super fun. Dimension 20, I've only actually listened to a couple Dimension 20s because I found them later in life, and and then, you know, you get busy with your own actual play podcast where I don't want yeah. them to seep into my brain.
Totally.
Okay, you don't have any fucking pots, you useless.
Where's our pots?
Where's all my pots, you fucks? Where's my fucking pots?
I think chat was also asking which pod you guessed it on. Some pods, is that right?
I did. A podcast that I listened to for a long, long time was Critical Bits, which is not Dungeons & Dragons. They play Masks. Which is a really fun system. It's it's not a D20 system. It is a system called Powered by the Apocalypse, which runs games like Masks and Monster of the Week, which can be an incredible amount of fun. You don't have any pots either. You fuck a lot.
Is it still like a fantasy based, or was it?
Yeah, it's still fantasy. So like Masks is like superheroes. You're a bunch of superheroes. That makes sense. There's another one over here, right? And Monster of the Week is think about like a Supernatural or a Buffy the Vampire Slayer, where it's like literally Monster of the Week. Oh, that's a lot of fun, yeah. And you can be some really neat characters.
Yeah.
So
and do you play like a? You just play like a regular human, like an X-Files agent.
You can, or you can play, you know, someone who like has a little bit of. Demonic something or another, you know.
Okay.
Be Blade.
You're not gonna be the full. You can't be like I'm Dracula.
Right. You can't be Dracula, but you could be like, you know, Dracula's cousin who's looking to take down Dracula, like half Hell Dracula, yeah. The old half track.
Old half track.
You don't have any. Road of Inquiry.
Is that the Six Flags Great America theme song?
Yeah, Great America theme song. Yeah, what about it?
I don't like that man, the man from those commercials, the old man.
You know, that was a lady.
No, yeah, really?
It's a lady dancer.
Incredible.
Hold me closer, lady dancer. that was a lady dancer, but I agree with you. The creepy man is very creepy.
Krashnikov says, got to recommend pretending to be people. which is a live play podcast. A Delta Green podcast, like Twin Peaks on meth.
Ooh, very fun. Yeah, there's a
there's one thing's twin one thing Twin Peaks needed. It was to be weirder.
Yeah, like Twin Peaks could have used a little meth, but I guess that's kind of season three.
Yeah,
but. But yeah, so like Critical Bits had me on. I've guested on a few, you know, D&D podcasts here and there, which have all been very fun. Unfortunately, I don't get to listen to them all as much as I would like to now because most of my time is spent editing audio of my own D&D, which, you know, you can't listen to audio while editing audio, which is, you know, which sucks because you want to. Here we are. Oh, there's no merchant over here. I thought there was a merchant.
We were lied to.
Okay, apparently I just don't know where the 20th pot is, and I'm not going to worry about it. All right, back to... Where are we going? Cancel. There we go. We're going to buy some more shit. Rikard? No, we're not going to do Rikard, because I can't explode Rikard, and so... His battle would just be a slog and a half. We're going to go take on
Malekith, right? Is that the next, or is there anyone before that?
Malekith, which is going to be terrible.
Yeah.
It's just going to be terrible. Or at least it was. It was terrible when I tried it in my practice run.
Do you feel like you are more prepared / higher leveled now than you were then?
I don't know. I might be. I might be higher leveled.
Okay.
I could
You've
go
grown as like a human, though.
Huh?
You've grown as like a human.
Like I feel like I have.
You've learned over the past couple, like, I don't know if you did this like 2 months ago.
Yeah.
Like, you've grown quite a bit.
I feel like I have more basic empathy as a human. Yeah, that's fair.
Yeah, yeah. Avi Rivera with a $5 donation. Thank you so much, Avi. Says, for the pots. Just wanted to show some support. Thanks for all the laughs. Thank you, Avi.
Thank you. Thank you for that. Yeah, we appreciate that. Now I have that song stuck in my head. Now I have
American Fear says, hey guys, sorry I'm late, just wanted to say that I beat the Fire Giant and God's Can Duo this weekend using nothing but the crossbow and a mimic tier. Incredible. Look at that, you're inspiring people.
You did it.
You're like Mother Teresa.
I'm just like, that's what I say often. I'm just like Mother Teresa. That's what I say very
You're
very
Mother
often.
Teresa's doppelganger.
You know what I didn't do in my test run is I didn't take out the horseman right before Malekith, which can be a problem.
Oh, the guy on the little walkway up there, he could be a pain.
Well, he can be a pain, but also he can be a big issue because if you bust out your mimic tier too soon, your mimic tier will want to fight him through the wall. All right, so we'll get that.
Oh, Nico Munka said the pot dealers are in North Limgrave, Castle Morn, Rampart, and Caelid South. Did we go to all those places?
We got the one in Limgrave. Where is that? We got the one. Oh yeah, here. Like we got the one that was in Limgrave. We got.
Nico said Castle Morn, Rampart, and Caelid South. I liked he accidentally typoed Carlos South, and I wish this game just had an area called Carlos.
Carlos South.
Yeah.
Which one's Castle Morn? That's Caelid.
No, that's a separate one. Castle Morn, Rampart. Castle Morn is Castle Morn the.
That
castle, the one just directly south of where you start, like the castle with the wolf on the beach that you fight at the end? The werewolf dude?
Oh.
Is that Castle Morn?
If that's Castle Morn, I have not been there.
I don't know if... Oh, yeah, that's where Leone is. Leone the Misbegotten.
There's a jar in Castle Morn?
I don't know. That's what Nico said. But they also said Carlos.
They also said... Okay, well, hold on. Let's get to the next... Let's get to the next dingle hopper over here, and then we will deal with that.
Weeping Peninsula.
Yes.
Oh, it was a jar dealer, pot dealer. So maybe is there a merchant, nomadic merchant, Castle Morn, Rampart? What do they sell? They sell crack pot? Is that what you're looking for?
That's what we're looking for.
They sell a crack pot?
That's what we're looking for. Shit. That'll learn me for not going to the Weeping Peninsula.
Yo, you gotta fight it. You gotta fight a werewolf on the beach. If a game gives you a werewolf on the beach, you gotta fight a werewolf on the beach.
You heard it here first.
As my old man used to say.
That's a very strange saying, but you know, we'll go with it.
Yeah, just extremely specific. Like, it just didn't seem like in my life I'd ever have to deal with that. But sure enough.
But here you are.
Yep.
Dealing with that. All right, we're gonna run past some dragons real quick. Run past some death birds. These birds. Whoop, not there.
Friggin' birds. Does the game reuse the Leone fight at all in, like, optional dungeons or anything like that? It seems like a lot of the enemies in the games are, like, reused, where you now have to fight two of them. But I'm trying to think, like,
yeah, that misbegotten Leone is refought if you go after Radahn, if you go back to that castle.
Yeah.
You know, like, where all the people are hanging out before the Radahn festival?
Yeah.
There's
like one in the courtyard.
There's like one, or there's two. There's him and a Crucible Knight. Oh fuck.
Oh no. Yeah. That's too much.
And it's a double fight. It's a fun fight. It's a real fun fight.
That's a lot of business though.
It's a whole lot of business. Oh, hold on. There's a stone here that I gotta grab real quick. Got to grab a stone, grab it with my baby hands.
George Lucas says, be careful. I heard Norman Reedus hangs out naked on beaches with babies.
There we go.
As a big fan of Death Stranding, I can confirm he does that.
Huh.
He's a big fan of umbilical cord beaches.
You know, Death Stranding is so flippin' interesting.
I feel like I'm about to get a butt.
No. There's a big butt here. There's like a Jennifer Lopez here, which is like,
ooh.
Oof, girl, first of all, girl.
Ooh.
Second of all, like, I love.
Did you know she changed her name to Jennifer Affleck officially?
Wait, they get remarried?
Yeah, they got married in Vegas.
What?
Yeah, just the other day.
Young love. Good for them.
Yeah.
You know what?
I thought she changed her name. Yeah, she's changing her name to Jennifer Affleck.
Good for them.
Oh, and then they want me to sign up for a newsletter? Get the fuck out of here. I'm not signing up for a newsletter. What are you doing, internet? You were talking about
a Jennifer Lopez newsletter?
Yeah, I don't know whose newsletter that. Maybe I should sign up for the Jennifer Lopez newsletter.
You have to sign up for the Jennifer Lopez newsletter. Yeah. Now. But no, my big butt is, like, the first 15 hours of Death Stranding, I think, is some of the most beautiful gameplay experiences I've ever had.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the intensity of balancing packages, that, like, min-maxing of, like, oh, I could get one more package on my back, and then, oh, but now I gotta sneak past the goopy umbilical monsters, mm-hmm. right? I fucking love that so much. And then the game literally undoes all of the tension slowly through the next 20 hours.
Yeah.
Where it's like, okay, now you get a motorcycle. Oh, I can do more, but it's still kind of tricky. Well, now you get a car. Oh, okay. Now you can build highways. Oh,
now you can just zip line wherever you want.
Now you can go wherever you want, whenever you want, and there's no challenge. Yeah. Oh, really?
But here's some boss battles, but I don't want boss battles. I don't want to fight bosses.
No, I wanted to, like,
that's not why I'm here.
I wanted to do, like, inventory management. That was the shit I was into. But like Tetris. some really beautiful ideas. Overall. Okay. We're gonna go get our last pot, and then we're gonna go fight Malekith. Where are we at? Oh, we're at 4:00. Great. We're at 4:00. It's fine.
Doing excellent. Proud of us.
We're doing great. We'll go a little past 5, obviously, because we started a little after 3. This guy. I never stopped by this guy. This is the guy right here.
He's hanging out right here.
He's just hanging out right here. I bet he's got up all the old pot for me. You know what I beat recently, which was great family time. Earlier, I meant to mention it earlier when you were talking about Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, was Shredder's Revenge.
Ooh, did you like it?
Oh, man, what a fun game.
Yeah, I had a lot of fun. We played through it on game night. I thought it was a blast.
Yeah, that was just the best. Okay, great. I got my last pot. We did it. We did it, everybody. We now have 20 pots. So you can we can have 10 fire and 10 volcanoes at all times. Boom. We got the pot head on, which means that our pots do extra damage. And
wonderful.
And we have the pot.
Maximum number of pots?
We have the maximum number of pots and the pot medallion, which means that our pots are doing more damage.
Mm-hmm.
So we are now fully potted.
We are potted.
All right. Let's do a Malekith.
If we were a store for white women, we'd be the Pottery Barn.
We'd be.
And I don't want to like type that because I've been in a Pottery Barn a couple times and I think it's pretty neat.
If we were minced up meat, we would be potpourri.
Oh,
that's a spelling
joke.
My
God,
that's a spelling joke.
That's a spelling joke. That's like a jamon toast.
Jamon toast.
Jamon toast.
Oh, lordy. All right.
Yeah, Malekith could be tough.
Malekith sucks.
But we need to deal with... Are you going to deal with this horseman first?
I'm going to say fuck it. I'm just going to run away from the horseman. I'm going to run away from the horseman, and I'm going to try not to summon my dudesies right away.
All right.
And dead already. Great. Malekith is a fast motherfucker.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like
the fight only gets harder.
Right. And it's been a while since I've fought him.
This might be us for the next hour.
This very well. You know, we'll give it like a few solid tries, and then we might fuck off and kill some dragons to level up. But hoo boy, I think a lot of it also is just mental. Like there's a mental block.
Yeah.
As far
there's
as
no NPC summon for this, is there?
There's no NPC summon. You know, maybe we can take out the tree sentinel and get a helper.
Yeah.
Oh, and the tree sentinel hit me through the gate.
What if there was an NBC summon where you could summon any character from primetime NBC history?
Would you be cool with that?
Yeah.
And I would be so cool with that.
There's a lot of, like, yeah, I'd get like Tina Fey from 30 Rock. I bet she'd be great. Tracy Morgan from 30 Rock, he would be really good. Frasier.
Oh my God.
He'd be good in the fight.
You get Tracy Morgan from 30 Rock, and you have pure chaos incarnate.
Yeah, he'd probably give you a buff by like lifting up his shirt and slapping his belly.
Okay, here we go. So now we have the Mimic tier out. So now we can do some distractions.
Yeah. Yeah, it's interesting because this fight, unlike almost every other boss fight, you can't just summon the Mimic tier as soon as we get in here.
Right.
You kind of have to run around the arena, find a safe spot, make sure he's a ways away to summon. Gelden says summon Alf. Could you imagine Alf? Alf would be incredible.
Malekith is a little cat.
Malekith is cool.
And Alf eats cats.
That's true.
That's a pure just saying. Get out of there, Mimic Tear. Get out of there. You're not strong enough to deal with them by yourself. No! Oh, fuck. Get out of there, me. You're not strong enough to deal with them by yourself. Okay. Oh, no. Okay. There we go. I also need to remember to, like, distract him enough so he doesn't fuck up my Mimic Tear too bad, because we still have a phase two.
Yeah.
Okay, we got to phase two. Sweaty palms.
Boo Radley. Sweaty palms. About Alf, Boo Radley says he's back in summon form. Beautiful. Pride and Ball says, can you upgrade your Mimic tier? Do we have anywhere further to upgrade our Mimic tier?
No, Mimic tier is at full.
Mimic tier is peaked.
Mimic tier is at full health. full everything, and almost dead, and dead, and I'm not dead yet, which is great. So now it's just the dodge game. Fuck, and I'm dead. Great. But you know what?
Yeah, got phase two, second try.
Yeah. That's promise. I don't think in my test run, I don't think I got to phase two.
Yeah.
Holy moly. Whew. I have to remember to use pots in phase one. Oh, also I have the remembrance of the fire giant that I never popped. So we can probably level up, but we'll do that later.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
We'll do that later. Oh, and I didn't pop my wondrous physic because I'm an idiot. and I have some crab legs too.
What are crab legs?
I have some boiled crab, which greatly boosts your physical damage negation for a time.
Oh, that's nice.
I'm just trying to think of what to have equipped for my mimic tier. So it's like if I give my mimic tier the crab legs, he might pop a crab leg, right?
And mimic tiers use items?
Oh yeah, they use items.
Oh, I didn't even know that. Will they count as your items?
No, they'll use them and then it's unlimited.
Oh, okay. Yeah. This is very good. What if you give your mimic tier a mimic tier and you create like infinite mimics?
About that. And then you've opened up the singularity.
That's not good. Yeah, you don't want that to happen.
Right.
Tarnished Pants said that Malekith stopped me in my tracks for a whole day. Yeah, Malekith's tough.
Malekith's
tough cookie. Tough cookie on a regular ass build.
Yeah. Like the one saving grace with Malekith is that he has relatively low health.
Yeah.
If you have a good strength build, then you can deal with that relatively easily.
Yeah.
Because, you know, he's just a couple hits here and there. All right, we're going to try running. But here, I'm doing chip damage, you know?
Yeah.
Just little bits at a time. Trying to find that opening for my jars. That was a good jar. That was a good jar throw. I like that. While he's scooping up gravel here, I'm going to use these pillars. I'm going to try to use these pillars to my advantage and get some good jar damage. Oh, fuck. Camera. Get fucked.
Nice. Good. That was nice jar damage. Yeah.
Yeah, we got some nice jar damage happening here because he's stuck behind the pillars a little bit. Excuse you.
So are you purposely holding out on using your mimic here?
Yes. Yeah. Because like
so that it could have more health in like phase two.
Yes. Yeah. That's my hope here is if I can chip him down far enough. Oh fuck! Oh fuck! He does so much fucking damage.
Yeah. He's a beefy boy.
Very happy that missed. Very happy that missed. How about fire? Nope. Nothing. Nope. God damn it. God damn you, Malekith.
Pure Pyro says using pillars to your advantage is Souls Tactics 101. Absolutely.
Yes.
Been doing that since Dark Souls.
You have to be careful because his little claw stuff, his like ground claws go through the pillar. The pillar. You know what? It's been. I've done enough damage where. Oh, fuck. I should summon just so I can distract him, but now we should be able to get him into phase two relatively
really quickly. Yeah, if it's both of you.
I'll drink my physic. Oh, fuck. All right. Fire damage now, so we'll throw some pots. Fuck you.
Meister Kleiser Heiser says, did someone point out that Bushy uploaded an Explosions Only run a week ago?
I did. I saw that. But
do you know who Bushy is?
Yes.
Bushy is Bushy.
Souls are. he's a soldier. He does challenge runs. But his explosion only was actually different than mine. He wasn't using the explosive bolts because he said no weapons.
Oh, so he was just using pots?
I didn't watch all of it yet. But yeah, he did a slightly different explosions only run.
Oh,
but
that's neat.
I thought it was Oh fuck, damn it. I got my phase two again, that's something. So yeah, his rule set is slightly different than mine, which I thought was interesting. I think he allowed magical explosion. He allowed anything that explodes that's not a weapon.
Yeah.
Which, you know, I think that's a neat aspect, is we can, you know, do essentially the same run with a slightly different rule set.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, we're going to give this one more try. Well, we'll give this a couple more tries. I feel like I had a good tactic. Maybe I popped the mimic tier a little too fast. I can get him down a little bit further before we pop the mimic tier. We'll give her a shot. We'll give her the old shot.
XLG says, is that a man bun Marty is sporting? It is not. That just might be a weird optical illusion because of my chair. So I do need a haircut, but I promise you there's no man bun. Not that I'm against man buns.
Marty, why are you against man buns?
I just realized by even bringing it up, I sort of like was very defensive.
Yeah, you were.
I should have just lied and be like, yeah, I got a bunch of man buns.
You are a man made of nothing but buns.
I would. That'd be delicious. Love buns.
Of all kinds.
I don't think I've never met a bad bun.
Malekith. The issue with Malekith and the pots and the arrows is underneath that cloak, he has a very thin body. So
yeah.
He has a very tiny hitbox.
Mm-hmm.
And so the pots and the arrows can get around him really easily.
Yeah. Malekith's other thing is that he's a big shithead.
Oh, like a huge shithead.
Yeah. He's like a real 80s rom-com villain. Not only is he a shithead, but he kind of commits a couple crimes as well. Bad dude. Bad dude top to bottom.
Yeah, like insider trading.
Oh, yeah. Oh, he does tons. Yeah.
Yeah, like not cool crimes either. Like
No.
Like
bad
yuppie
crimes. Yeah.
Not yucky crimes, yuppie crimes.
Yuppie crimes,
which
yeah.
are somehow
yeah.
worse.
Yeah, he was a big Halliburton guy. Remember Halliburton?
I
he did a bunch of that. Yeah.
He did a bunch of Halliburton?
Did a bunch of Halliburton? Sounds like a drug. I'm going crazy with some Halliburton. Enron? He was definitely part of Enron.
Oh, yeah. He was super Enron. Oh, fuck.
Yeah. Grunger says the late game bosses just do a stupid amount of damage. Yeah, I definitely think the last like quarter of this game definitely ramps up in difficulty. At least it did for me.
Oh, yeah. Damn it. Okay. It gets stupid. It gets... Okay, here we go.
Alexandra says Bernie Malikoff. Beautiful. Beautiful. George Lucas says that Malekith did booze and gambling during Elliot Ness times. Those crimes are too cool. Those
yeah,
are
no,
like...
Yeah,
yeah like running speakeasies and gambling when they were during Prohibition. Those were cool crimes.
Oh, fuck. My mimic tier goes down so goddamn fast.
Yeah.
In phase two, like... My mimic tier is down already.
Malekith just goes fucking hog wild. He goes whole hog.
He goes
puts his whole hog into it. Maggie says the camera is what really did it in for me with this fight. I had no idea what I was doing for the 2 seconds I was alive. Yeah, because his problem is that he's big and he's fast, and that's like a bad combo. Because the camera can handle big or fast, but usually not both.
Oh, fuck. Well, we made it a little bit farther that time. We made it a little bit farther that time.
Slow and steady wins the race.
Oh. We might have to do some dragon hunting to raise. I mean, I don't even know. I'm just trying to think of what levels to raise here even. Oh, actually, you know what we can try here? We'll try popping a rune arc. We haven't been doing that.
That's true. We haven't been doing that.
So now we're slightly beefier. And yeah, we'll give it another try with a rune arc, and then we'll just go defeat. We'll go beat up some dragons because we want to take out our rage on something.
We'll just go kill some defenseless dragons.
Basically, like, we're going to pick on dragons.
Yeah. Oh, speaking of earlier, we were talking about D&D. Did you see the trailer for the D&D movie?
I did see the trailer for the D&D movie. And I don't know if this is a hot take or not, but I thought it looked really fun.
So did I. Yeah, I thought it, like, really captured the vibe of the... I was saying this before on the stream, of... sort of the current trend of lighthearted D&D.
Yeah.
While still clearly, like, they clearly give a shit about D&D, but are trying to get sort of a Guardians of the Galaxy-ish vibe from it. I don't know. I think it looks nice.
It looks like a ton of fun. I am down for just Chris Pine being in, you know, more things in general.
I said he's the best Chris. I think he's the best Chris. I think he's better than Hemsworth. I think he's better than Pratt. I think he's better than... Evans, he's the secret best Chris. I think he's the secret best Chris. I like Chris Evans a lot. I think he's secret best.
You know what? I'll give Chris Pine best Chris only because of how underrated he is.
Okay.
Because everyone thinks about Captain America, and everyone loves Chris Evans.
Yeah.
And so you're like, okay, yeah, I'll give it to Pine as like an underdog vote.
Gotcha. Dingus said the D&D film with Jeremy Irons was great. Dingus, we're all entitled to our opinions except for that one. You right. need to like, return that opinion.
We're not playing that game.
We're not doing it. Boo Radley says, what about Chris Kattan? Yeah, where does Chris Kattan rank in the no. pantheon of Chris's?
Chris Kattan ranks at no.
Chris O'Donnell? He's an underrated Chris. Whatever happened to Chris O'Donnell? Does he still do stuff?
That's, you know.
He was Robin, and then he's not here anymore.
Yeah, what's Chris? Well, he was on like one of those like CSI shows for a while.
Oh yeah, he probably made like infinite money off. It was probably one of those shows that like got more viewers than anything we watch on cable.
Right.
Ooh, Andrew with a great point. What about Chris Christopherson? It's 2-for-1 sale. He's a double Chris.
And yeah. Chris Christopherson is, we would know him because he is a musician who did the song.
Ooh. He was one of the Highwaymen. Remember the Highwaymen?
What? Now you're making stuff up.
No, there was a super group called the Highwaymen. It was him, Johnny Cash,
you're a liar.
Willie Nelson,
a liar.
And a fourth.
All the time. Why do you lie all the time?
Waylon Jennings. They had a song called The Highwayman. That was great. Just an excellent song.
I just feel like you're lying.
I'm not lying. It's a top 25 song ever.
Top 25 song ever?
It's one of my 25 favorite songs ever. I'm going to drop Highwayman. Highwayman is being dropped in the chats. Everyone, feel free to listen to Highwayman at your leisure. He also, Chris Christopherson, played Whistler in the Wesley Snipes Blade movies.
You know what? A fine Chris.
He's great Chris, yeah.
I don't know, like, you know, he gets bonus points because he has two Chris's in his name, but I don't know if he has anything else that will put him above a Pine.
Yeah, and it's one of those things where it's like more, you know, like you can go to an all-you-can-eat buffet, but if the food is shitty... I would rather have a small portion of something really good.
Yeah.
Chris Farley. Yeah, I'm an absolute all-time Chris. Yeah. Take it from us too soon.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't like what's going on there. I don't like this Chris Farley erasure coming from you.
I think Farley was an incredibly talented comedian.
Yeah.
Who relied a little too heavily on a single shtick.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, I think that was part of the downfall of,
yeah,
of
yeah.
Chris is like his own like what do you call that? Because he felt like he would never be good enough, right?
And that's a self-fulfilling prophecy almost.
Well, you know,
he had to keep kind of pushing it and pushing it.
Yeah, and that led him. I think that led him down a dark path, and I think he didn't challenge himself in appropriate ways.
Cool. Yeah, I don't know if just maybe he sadly never got to that point, because I would say, his contemporaries like Adam Sandler never showed the dramatic chops until a bit later on in their career with stuff like Punch Drunk Love and then going into Uncut Gems and stuff like that. I would even say a similar thing with like Jim Carrey. He didn't really go quote unquote serious until The Truman Show, was it? Maybe?
Fair.
Yeah.
Fair.
David Spade, he never went serious until my upcoming drama, All Quiet on the Western Front, starring David Spade.
Wow.
Yeah.
Mimic Tear is distracting Malekith. Mimic Tear is almost dead already. Hey, Malekith, I'm shooting you.
Malekith, your dog. Bertatone subscribed to Tier 1 over on Twitch, been a member for 26 months. Holy moly, says boom, bang, kablooey.
Thank you. You get it.
Yeah, Giggle Man, I love the Truman Show. I think it's great. Truman Show, Man on the Moon, good stuff. Bunch more Chris's. People are starting to get a little loosey-goosey with best Chris's. We got Christina Ricci, Christina Aguilera, Christopher Walken. All good Chris's. Could Chris be the best name in terms of, like, are there the most best Chris's?
Here's a real hot take. Is Christopher Walken does not count as best Chris because he is not a Chris.
He's Christopher?
He's a Christopher.
And so Christina wouldn't either.
Yeah.
None of the Ricci's, Aguilera.
I apologize. As you know, Genie in a Bottle, very formative to many young men. Gonna get dirty! but that's a Christina.
Also, that was a great run. By the way, that was a great run.
Thank you. Yeah, yeah. I felt really good about that. Okay, yeah, so we have a big issue with Malekith. Which is, like, I was able to get him, one, I forgot to craft before the boss fight. I'm able to get him to second phase using only bolts, which is great. Mm-hmm. Then we hit a point in which the Mimic Tear does a good enough job to distract him so I can pop all of my vials, but then dies immediately.
Yeah.
So, one, I'm going to remember to actually craft this time.
Okay, we're going to craft. We can do some leveling up, right?
Maybe we can, yeah. Okay, so we're going to actually craft this time.
Andy Anaka with a $2 donation. Thank you so much, Andy. Says, what about Christmas? # put the Chris back in Christmas.
Oh, my fucking
put
God.
Put the Chris back in Christmas. Chris Crocker? Who's Chris? I don't even know who Chris Crocker is.
Chris Crocker.
Can't be the best Chris if I don't even know who that is. Is that like the inventor of the Crocker Pot?
That's the inventor of the Crocker Pot, yeah. If you like slow cooking, thanks, Chris Crocker.
There's Chris, Christopher Cracker Barrel, the inventor of the Cracker Barrel.
Christopher Cracker Barrel. First of all, beautiful.
Yeah.
All right. Let's sell all of our shit that we don't need.
I feel like Cracker Barrel and Pottery Barn could swap their names and nothing would change. Like, you could go buy a bunch of your chintzy shit at the Cracker Barrel and then go eat a big old meal of grits and gravy at the Pottery Barn.
Grits and gravy.
Yeah.
Nice. I always hate selling armor in case I want it later. So we're not.
Yeah, yeah. Like if you really want to play some Elden Bling.
Right. All right, we're going to sell all this.
We'll save a few of them in case we need to buy shit later, but that should get us at least a level.
Oh, Chris Crocker is apparently the Leave Britney Alone guy. I did not know that.
Oh, okay. Started a movement.
Did start
started a goddamn movement.
Also, like, as goofy as people made fun of him, like, the idea of leave celebrities alone and don't be mean to them was right. Really good. I think a really good little message.
Agreed. Should we just go all vigor? Should we just say fuck it and go all vigor? Probably.
Oops, all vigor. That's my favorite cereal.
Oh, and if I get 42475, 42475, I can get one more level here. 42475, 42475. 42475. I'm saying that. I keep saying that out loud so I know how many to sell. Sell this. Sell this. Sell that. Sell that.
The man on top says Chris Angel, the mind freak. I don't like him because he's got dark powers. So I don't want to talk about Chris Angel.
He's literally a mind freak.
Yeah, I don't want to give any airtime to mind freaks. American Fear says, oops, I vigored again.
Right? Maybe a little to stamina. Well, that gets us one more stamina. That's not going to help us. A little bit to strength. That'll boost up. Yeah, no. Oops, all vigor. 40 vigor. All right. That gives us significantly more health.
That's
let's
good.
Let's go get a victory under our belt. Let's go kill a defenseless dragon.
Perfect. And if we have more health, that means our stun double has more health, correct?
Correct. So let's go kill some dragons. Oh, do I have any? I think I'm out of gold. I think I'm out of goldie foots, but I have the thing.
The pickle. You're out of picklebacks?
I'm out of extra pickles, but I have the oops always pickles.
Oops always pickle. Yeah, you have the pickle Christmas ornament that weird Germans and Poles put on their trees.
Finds the pickle. No, it is an ornament. Yeah. No, it's not sex. It's a find in my Schmeiden. That's significantly worse. It's a find in my Schneiben. Now I feel bad. I feel bad about finding my Schneiben, but I said it, so here we are.
You know what? Every once in a while on a Monday afternoon, you need to find in your Schneiden.
Gotta find in my Schneiben.
We're sorry, Meister Kleister Heister. We apologize for all that.
I do not.
Okay, one of us apologizes for all that. But the other one cancels out the apology, yeah. So it's back to stage zero. Chuk89 says, the existence of Chris Angel implies the existence of Chris Demon. I feel like those would be like a Pokemon Red and Blue scenario.
100%.
Like, you go to the store and you're like, do you want Chris Angel or do you want Chris Demon?
Or buy the bundle and get them both.
That would be, yeah, that's insane. Anyone who buys two Pokemon games is nuts. Anyone who buys two Chris's, both Angel and Demon, you're crazy. Chris Cornell, Legendary Chris, agree with that.
Oh, yeah, that's a good one. We all like Chris Cornell.
Yeah.
Okay, by the way, like, I love that. With all my pot extravaganza, like, I was able to take down that dragon with 9 fire pots. I didn't use a single anything else. That's beautiful.
Hell yeah.
That's beautiful. Okay, that gets us a little something.
Steel-clad gamer asks, what are grits? Grits are like a porridge made with like cornmeal or hominy or something like that. It's like big in the American South.
It's kind of like an oatmeal, but made of less healthy things than oats.
Yeah, and it's one of those things that's like very much a vessel for the things you want to put on it, so you can kind of sweeten them up, or you can have grits be kind of like the starch in like a breakfast. Yeah, I didn't grow up with a lot of grits. I'm not a huge gritzer.
Yeah, neither am I. Just because, like, to me, it's like, you know, like even pancakes, where you're like, why, like, this is nothing but something for butter and syrup. Like, the, you know, and I enjoy pastries. I enjoy donuts, but just eat a donut at that point.
Yeah. Who are you trying to fool?
Yeah.
When we have mind freaks in the world, you're not fooling anybody. At that point, there's no secrets between you, your god, and your mind freak.
I might need Monsieur
Mimic. It says Chris Columbo, the TV detective. Is Columbo's first name Chris? like of the show Columbo?
If it is, that is news to me.
That can't be right. I feel like you made that up.
If Columbo's first name is Chris, this is the first I'm hearing about it.
Yeah, and I have like an RSS feed for Columbo news.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm getting out of there.
Tell me what the fuck Columbo's first name is. How is this taking so long?
Nope.
Frank Columbo. Is his name Frank Columbo?
That doesn't sound right either.
Frank, he sounds more like a Franco Columbo. Ooh, how am I? How is it so hard to find out Columbo's real name? What is Columbo's first name? Columbo's first name was never explicitly revealed in the series. However, when Columbo flashes a badge in the episode Dead Weight, season 1, episode 3, as we all know, the name Frank can clearly be seen on his ID.
No. Frankie Columbo.
Yeah, that sounds like a real Columbo name. Then Dingus just says, oh, I was thinking of Chris Columbus. Christopher Columbus might be a low... That's a low tier. That's a low tier, Chris.
Are you talking about Chris Columbus, exploiter and slave trader, or are you talking Christopher Columbus, noted director?
Oh, I love the director, the dad who did Mrs. Doubtfire and Harry Potter.
Yeah.
He's great.
He's great.
Yeah, he's great.
Okay, great.
Yeah.
Literally, like, historical buffoon or noted director. Great.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. The visionary behind the hit Mrs. Doubtfire.
Great. Then I'm with you.
Yeah. I think Chris Columbus also wrote Home Alone.
Oh.
I want to say.
You know what? That's just me not knowing.
It was him and John Hughes, and they tag teamed it in some way.
I'll believe you.
Directed by Chris Columbus, written by John Hughes. I got it mixed up. But yeah, Home Alone. Big movies. Home Alone, Harry Potter, Mrs. Doubtfire. What a career. What else you got going on? Chris Columbus, what do you got going on?
What you got going on, dog?
Wrote Gremlins? Ever fucking heard of it? Wrote Goonies? What? What a time. What a time to be alive. Bicentennial Man? I don't want anything to do with that movie. Directed Pixels? Very bad video game movie?
Very bad video game movie.
Yeah. Christmas with the Cranks? That's one of the top 10 Chris. Is Christmas with the Cranks?
It's Christmas.
Yeah.
I guess it has to be. Just because we know so few Chris's.
I think it turns out we know a lot of Chris's. Christopher Tootin is in the chat right now saying, heard you're talking about Chris's in here.
Yeah.
Are people starting to share this chat with, like, maybe people are sharing the stream with Chris's they know.
These are the Chris's I know, I know. These are the Chris's I know. Some of them are Chris's, but most of us are Christopher's. That's a little Kids in the Hall reference.
That was beautiful.
Oh my god, what is this dragon doing? Look at this dragon's messed up AI. Like it's like climbing a wall and spew above the rock wall. I'm taking advantage.
It looks like he's trying to make love to the wall. I appreciate it.
Guess what, dragon? I'm using it. It counts. Still counts as a win.
Pure Pyro says, which comedian do you prefer, Steve Martin or John Candy?
Potato, potato. Or not potato, potato. That's apples and oranges, my friend. That's...
Yeah.
One is a comedic actor, one is a comedian. And, by the way, they have two different roles. You know, one is a born setup man, everyday man, and the other is the jokester, so...
Yeah.
The obvious answer is them together in Planes, Trains, and Automobiles.
Yeah.
So.
What do you prefer between Planes, Trains, and Automobiles?
You know what? Watch me be a dickhead and say Trains.
I wish I liked Trains more. I like the idea of Trains the most.
Yeah.
But I think America has beaten my love of them out of me because the American train industry is just dreadful.
Are we counting subways as trains?
Yeah, I would say anything on rails can be a train.
Yeah, trains are there. Like, I agree with you. Like, America is not built for trains, but that doesn't diminish my love for trains.
Yeah. I just wish I wish I could be like, I want to go to the West Coast and have the train be like a viable option. Not even necessarily a bullet train, but just like a cool. I just want to be part of a murder mystery on a train. That's all I want.
Specifically,
or a murder mystery on a riverboat gambling tour.
Ooh, better.
Yeah.
Okay, wait. Where am I? Oh, yeah. We're going to. I forget whether or not we defeated this tree. I just want to train to Vegas. Like, every once in a while, people float around here in Milwaukee. I guess, like, a little. They float these around everywhere. Places that don't have good public transportation. And unfortunately, Milwaukee is a place that doesn't have good public transportation. And so people will, like, mock up. Like, if Milwaukee had a rail system.
Yeah.
And it's like, oh, my God, I would fucking love that so much.
Yeah, could you imagine being able to, like, easily get out to, like, fucking Brookfield, get down to Kenosha?
Oh,
like,
just
a quick
anywhere.
Zip to Chicago or
right?
to Madison? Yeah.
Oh, like, there was... Did I beat this tree sentinel? I did beat this.
Was there a proposal? Like, what's his name? Like, Scott Walker?
Scott Walker poo-pooed it down.
Yeah.
Instead, he funneled a bunch of money for freeway widening, which does nothing for improving traffic.
Yeah. Yeah. And then Foxconn, which is just like a cool Chris Angel mind freak of billions of dollars in taxpayer money.
Oh, Foxconn. Every once in a while, I forget about the Foxconn debacle, and then someone will post, like, the picture of, look at the Foxconn that was never built, and it makes me laugh every time.
Yeah. I like, because every time someone mentions it, they call it a boondoggle. And we don't get enough things in life that are, like, officially labeled boondoggles.
Right. That is the boondoggliest.
It is. It is. Chris Angel boondoggle.
Of all boondoggles.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Okay, so we got to remember to craft. Always remember to craft. All right, we're going to go take on this dragon, which I don't think we beat yet. We didn't. All right, we're going to drink a potion. We're going to summon the mimic. Because why not? Like, we can do whatever we want all the time.
So we're no cops. There's no cops in the lands betwixt. I
really hope not. I'm the law.
I am the law.
Is that Judge Dredd?
Yeah.
I'm the law.
Yeah. What do you have you seen the newer Judge Dredd as well with Carl Urban?
Dredd.
Billy Butchers.
Yeah.
That movie's great.
Dredd is a fantastic film did very poorly at the box office, so probably will never be repeated.
Yeah.
But just a fantastic film.
Yeah.
They did exactly what they needed to do, you know, which was, I mean, basically like a big budget remake of The Raid.
The Raid, yeah.
Which, again, great call.
Also great movie. Yeah.
Great movie. Great movie, great call. I haven't seen it yet, but apparently Hulu's The Princess is
just the same premise.
Is a very Raid-like, but it's a princess escaping a tower, and it's like, oh, I've heard it's like pure unadulterated action schlock, which I'm like, oh, I gotta watch that.
Yeah, it's like if like Rapunzel was like, fuck this, I'm out, and just beat the shit out of guards like floor after floor.
Exactly, like that's what I want.
Also, someone needs to make a movie like that with a Rapunzel whose hair is like a million feet long, because I feel like you can get all sorts of unique scrapes and scraps with hair that long.
I mean, that's kind of what Rapunzel is. They did that.
That's literally the story of Rapunzel. I think I just tried to pitch the story of Rapunzel. This is why every time I go to Hollywood and I'm like, I got this big idea, and at the end of it, they're like, that was just James Cameron's Avatar. Why are you wasting our time?
Yeah, just
stop
pitching us James Cameron's Avatar.
Yeah.
Where is...
We tell that to James Cameron as well. He keeps coming in and they're like, just make it, please. Stop talking about it.
Stop talking. Also, stop making avatars. Stop it.
Please.
Stop it.
Please.
Stop it. We're done.
Storm Templar says, why are we grinding dragons? Storm Templar, go to the nearest mirror. Say, why are we grinding dragons? And think about why any human being would ever question grinding dragons. That sounds like it's like literally the coolest fucking thing.
Yeah. This is pure levels. We just need some levels. Already with the dragons we've killed, I've gotten another vigor and another strength. So we're just getting some levels. One, also just getting some victories under our belts after some Malekith defeats. And then, but no, this is pure levels so we can attempt Malekith again and maybe do a little bit better. And I think, yeah, there is an Ice Dragon Boy around here somewhere. Gotta find him. We're gonna beef up now.
Beefy boys. American Fear said, speaking of princesses, someone needs to tell Zoomers about The Princess Bride so they can stop giving me funny looks when I say it's my favorite movie and then have to explain that it's a comedy. Is that not, I feel like that's one of those movies. Do kids not watch? I guess kids don't watch. Kids don't watch anything. What do kids watch? Like, what are your kids' favorite movies?
Kids watch TikTok.
Kids watch TikTok.
Right?
It's great.
What are my kids' favorite movies? You know, like, we watch a lot of movies, obviously, because I'm a movie guy.
Yeah.
And so I don't know if my children have a favorite movie just because we watch so many of them.
Yeah. Are they into, like, Star Wars or Marvel or any of that? Like,
no, not necessarily. You know, we watch all the Marvel movies. We've seen all the Star Wars, but mostly just because... Oh, not all the Star Wars, not the newer stuff. But, like, really, again, that's just because, like, my wife and I are big Marvel heads.
Yeah, yeah.
They are not necessarily. Stop it.
Yeah, there's just so much more stuff now competing for our attention. Like, when we were kids, like, if I got, like, a VHS, just, like, I watched The Lion King until, like, the thing didn't work anymore.
Yeah. I took them to see Moonfall. Is what I will tell you. And they had the best time watching Moonfall, which I agree with.
Oh, hell yeah.
Because Moonfall is fucking great. So, you know, I'm teaching them schlock appreciation.
Good. I feel like that's a skill people need to learn early. And kind of relearn. I think people forget how to appreciate, like, the nice trash.
The nice trash.
Yeah, it's good trash. I don't know. It's like dumpster diving. It could be good trash.
Yeah. Also, yeah, finally, my Mimic tier shows up. Like, about damn time I summoned you 80 million years ago.
Oh, you didn't realize that after that last Malekith fight, they joined the Union.
Damn
and
it.
So they kind of dictate when they show up now.
Damn it. I knew it. Elden Ring is union busting propaganda.
Thanks a lot, Bezos.
Why did Amazon pay for Elden Ring? That seems.
Oh, now it makes sense.
Oh. Fuck, 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 fuck. Stupid ice roar. He has an ice roar. That's stupid. I don't even know if I'll get another level out of him. But at this point,
Oscar says, if it's just about grinding levels, why don't you just go to the Blood Palace and trick the big bird into jumping off a cliff?
Oh yeah.
I don't think we haven't gotten to the Blood Palace yet, have we?
Yeah, we've got. Well, we haven't gotten to the Blood Palace, but I'm in the Blood World. Like there is a farm. You know, there's the Albernaic farm. Right at the beginning of the Blood Palace. Mm-hmm. If you've ever done that, yes, please summon my steed.
I don't think I did do that. I think the only farms I did were a couple of the early game ones. We did in the first or second stream with the where the boulder appears out of nowhere and you kind of got it off the cliff.
Yeah, that's a good one. There's a shit ton of second stage Albernaics. I'm out of pots. Oh shit, now I'm in. I'm in for a penny, in for a pound.
Fuck yeah.
So yeah, there's a spot where like I could farm, but remember everyone, farming isn't necessarily useful for me if I use my bolts, which is of course where I am now with the dragon. I was like, I've used too many bolts. Because every bolt costs something.
Yeah, this is not a fiscally responsible build.
No, no. So I have to be very careful when and how I use bolts. That being said, I'm doing a terrible job at it because I'm wasting so many of them on this stupid-ass dragon. But I started fighting it, so I'd like to finish fighting it. Do most of it on my horse, so most of it's pretty easy.
Yeah.
Come on. Come on.
George Lucas says, I farmed by destroying everything where I went.
yeah, that's another.
I don't think that's less like farming. That's just called like pillaging.
That's
just pillage.
That's also just playing. You're just playing the game.
This is called playing the video game. You're like playing it correctly.
That's
yeah.
like the intended route. That's not farming. That's.
Yeah.
Which is okay.
That's living. That's just living the dream. That's.
All right. I'll be honest. It is kind of awesome that like I'm literally just like exploding this dragon. We're playing this game as a third-person shooter, which you know is a lot of fun.
Yeah. Also, chat. If any of you have watched Breakout, big news that Nick is going to be very excited about: a live-action Aragorn series is finally happening at Disney Plus, with that child writer serving as the showrunner.
The child.
Jack, do you remember those books, Aragorn? E-R-A-G-O-N.
Yes, I do remember those books.
So, yeah, that was like a relatively popular series of fantasy books that was riding like a post-Harry Potter wave.
Yeah.
It was written by like a literal 15-year-old.
Oh, was it? I did not know that.
Yeah, oops, I'm a baby writer. All of a sudden, I wrote these books.
Oops. like, he didn't write them on accident, did he?
No, and he also like wasn't a baby. He was But the only human being I ever have heard talk about it in the last 15 years is Nick Calandra.
Yeah.
And he keeps saying how it's rife for a modern adaptation and to be brought back. And I just make fun of him every time. And sure enough, it's coming to Disney Plus. So what the fuck do I know?
Beautiful. Beautiful. Whew. Oh, first of all, that dragon was incredibly worth it. That dragon was incredibly worth it. That gave us a ton of damn levels.
Heck yeah.
And by a ton, I mean, like, we're going to get 3 at the end of the day, but I'm just going to be okay with that. That was a lot of dang runes. All right, so what do we do here? We'll get strength up to 40. Maybe get endurance up and then another vigor, I guess.
Steelclad Gamer said his parents own a publishing company. At first, I thought you meant Nick's, and I thought that'd be really funny if it turned out the reason Nick only talks about it was because his parents own the rights to it. I'm assuming you meant the kid's parents.
The kid's parents own it.
Also, he was a kid. Like, he's probably the kid. He might literally be older than me, so I should probably stop calling him the kid. Christopher Paloni. Ooh, mamma mia. I wrote a book about a dragon.
That's like Taylor Swift, like, you know, started so young, but her dad like literally owned the record company that produced her music.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, that's significantly less special.
Yes, he's 38. He's older than me, so I don't know what to say. I will stop calling him the kid. He did write Aragorn when he was 15, though.
Okay, that's a kid. That counts as a kid.
Yeah. What was the most accomplished thing you did at the age of 15? By the time you were 15.
Oh, fuck. No, nothing. Like,
I'm literally trying to think of, like, what... Mine might be, like, beating Final Fantasy VII. That might have been, like, the most impressive thing I did.
Sure.
Up until that point.
Get the mannequin. By the time I was 15, I made... Okay. Did I talk about this on the last stream? I just told this story to someone. And I forgot whether or not I told this on stream. I made, so back in the day, the reason I got into comedy was because myself and my cousin, spent a lot of time with each other and we're comedy nerds, made each other laugh. We got super obsessed with Adam Sandler's comedy records, which weren't like normal stand-up records. They were, you know, skits. They were audio skits.
Oh, yeah. His first albums were incredible.
Right.
Yeah.
Super funny stuff. And so my cousin and I wanted to make our own comedy skit tape. And we set up a recording studio, which was like literally a microphone and a cassette recorder, like on his parents' home gym equipment. So we could like dangle the microphone appropriately. And we made a comedy tape. I mean, that by any standards is absolutely awful.
Wait, was this the Russian guy who wanted to play football?
No, I did that as a professional.
No, literally, as you were talking about this, I'm like, wait, did you tell this story? Is this the Russian guy who played football? Because these are all like different details.
No, so we made a comedy tape and we sent it to our local radio station. Because, of course, you know, they had a morning show. And so we sent it to our local radio station to see if they would play any of our comedy bits. They would not, because they were, by the way, incredibly inappropriate. But they had us on their morning show. They invited us to their morning show to talk to us. They're like, we got two young comedians here, and they put out a comedy tape. And he's like, we legally, for standards reasons, cannot play any of the tape. And he starts like describing our skits. And, but you know, this is, you know, we recorded this when we were 14, 15 years old. And so he's like, cause like one of the skits, he's like, I'll break it down for you. This was like, I'm the morning show MC. He's like, one of the skits was like a psychiatrist, and the psychiatrist would just get, you know, constantly get new patients in. And no matter what the patient said, the diagnosis was, you're gay. Oh, it was hilarious. Because like that was literally the 5-minute audio only skit.
Yeah,
would be like, oh yeah, welcome to my office, come in to see me. And then, you know, the other one would pretend to, like, you know, clop, 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 come in and be like, oh doc, I'm feeling so depressed because of work lately, and I feel like I have so much stress. Oh, I see, obviously you are gay. No doc, it's not that, it's, you know, like, and literally that was the only joke in the sketch. And so by 15, we were, our local morning DJ had us on as guests.
Incredible. So you did have, you did do something monumental by the age of 15.
Monumental.
Yeah, yeah.
In recent times, we have both completely scoured both ours and our parents' houses to see if we can find a copy of this tape.
Yeah.
Oh, luckily we cannot.
Had you been born in this sort of 15 in this modern age,
yeah,
do you think you would have been able to become like internet famous at the age of 15?
Definitely. Only because I was able to become internet famous, you know, when I became internet famous. Like,
yeah.
Like we.
But you were able to get those bad ideas out at a young age.
Oh, sure.
Like, if you would have just led, like, your first pitch was that as an adult, like, or that the world could have. That
my
would
first
have been great.
Pitch.
Yeah.
That would be terrible. If that was my first pitch, that would be terrible.
Yeah.
No, I think, like, you know, we, my cousin and I, my cousin Jake, Jakey Szymanski, who is now, you know, big-time Hollywood director.
Ooh.
He's the one I've told stories, like, you know, we worked at Funny or Die together for many, many years. We've always made stuff together. And yeah, if it would have been great having grown up in the age of the internet. Cause like the biggest struggle for us was always like cameras and editing, you know, like our camera was never good enough. We never had a nice enough computer to edit with, and so like edits just took forever. It was always a big pain in the butt, and now everyone has like a beautiful camera right on their phone. They can edit the videos right on their phone. Like short form has dominated.
Yeah.
Like quick sketch things have dominated the medium, which is, you know, I think is fantastic because I really enjoy stuff like that.
I looked up his name, Jake Szymanski. So your cousin was Jake Szymanski?
Is Jake Szymanski. Is currently Jake
Szymanski. I saw The Package. He directed The Package. I thought that was great.
Netflix.
Best movie about a wiener getting cut off.
Netflix's The Package, which, yeah, is phenomenal. He also did,
I saw he did Mike and Dave Need Wedding Dates.
Mike and Dave Need Wedding Dates. Yes, which is, you know, very...
That was Zac Efron, Anna Kendrick,
very
Albert
classic
Plaza.
Boner comedy. About two bros who need dates to go to a wedding.
It's a couple bros, couple boners.
Couple bros, couple boners.
Yeah.
You know, the hits.
The hits. We don't play the hits here at Boner Talk. Most Chaotic Archon, welcome to bonus access, as well as Roberto Del Fuego, welcome to early access. Please enjoy the latest episode of Adventurers Nigh. Episode 7 is available to you now. The newest extra punctuation is also available to you. Soon we will have a quest log. All sorts of things.
Oh, yeah. Episode 7, super fun. Episode 7, Adventurers Nigh, it was so much fun to edit. Like, a ridiculous amount of fun to edit. You know, it's a little combat heavy, which isn't fun to. It was ridiculously fun to animate. What I've discovered is that combat is not very fun to edit. But it is incredible to animate. Like, you can have a lot of fun in the animation of combat, but editing out all of the rules and the rolling is nothing but a pain in the ass. Oh, I definitely rolled in time. I 100% rolled in time. The game is broken. This run is invalidated.
Michael Zaki, you have ruined my life.
That was clearly...
Storm Templar with the Highland Master says you should convince your cousin to remake Ryan's Babe.
He wouldn't be able to do it justice.
Yeah.
He's doing a lot of commercial work now. Like, his most recent thing, the thing that did very well is, you know, the Uber Eats commercials where the people are, like, eating other things.
Oh, yeah. It's like the guy from Succession, Cousin Greg, the big guy, and he's, like, eating tape or whatever.
Exactly, because now they...
Oh, he did those?
Yeah, so he did those. Those were his most recent things.
Those were, like, I think those were during the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
Those were big game spots.
Those were big game spots. Yeah, very fun. So, he does a lot of commercial work now.
Nice.
And yeah, still living that comedy dream. Oh, fuck. All right, we can only give Malekith like one more try here because we're already... I know we started late, but we're running late. And I don't know if we're going to be able to do this. I don't know if I got it in me. Or do we just beat the horse? Oh, I can't summon my mimic for the horse guy. Oh, fuck.
Oh, because you're not in... That's right.
Oh, that sucks.
So what's your game plan for next time? Like, what are you going to do to be prepared for next
time? Can
that sounds
we
like
do?
I'm, like, trying to challenge you, but I'm not. I'm just literally asking.
No, that's the question, is what do we do to beat Malekith? And I don't know if there is anything better than just getting good, right?
Yeah.
Is fighting him a bunch and learning those patterns so that I don't suck so much.
Yeah, and then maybe getting a kind of a lucky roll with the mimic not being slaughtered immediately, that kind of thing.
Excuse you, I have pressed my throw things button twice, and it threw them neither times. Michael Zaki, now the only
vintage
thing.
Vintage Michael. Can't be bothered. Can't be bothered to implement a throw button.
Now, that's again, I pressed the throw button and it didn't throw.
He's just like a little gremlin throwing a bunch of rocks at you, like a nuisance.
I love those bestial powers though. Like, that's so much fun. That was my problem with my next challenge run of Sticks and Stones, which I thought was going to be really complicated, because at first it was like, oh, I'll use the Briars of Sin, which is a super badass incantation. But, it takes a long time to wind up. But, like, if you can get it, if you can get it to bleed properly, oh, fuck, it can do a ton of damage.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's like, oh, Sticks and Stones, that's fun. Sticks and Stones breaks bones. And then as soon as I use Stone, it's like, oh, nothing else matters.
Yeah.
That bestial sling is so good.
Pew Pew Migu says maybe it's time for some jolly cooperation. Yeah, ooh. I mean, ultimately, that might be are you totally averse to calling in help?
Absolutely not. Absolutely not averse to calling in help.
Because we've had some summon NPC summons.
Oh, yeah.
Some of our favorite ones have helped with some of the big bosses. Those have been fun.
The question is, do I summon help now and try to get a win before we leave?
The choices are yours and yours alone. As Olmec, the hit host of Legends of the Hidden Temple, would say.
Well, I guess, you know, we're still in the middle of a fight, so we should probably just finish out this fight first.
Yeah. And the first thing I looked up in the mimic tier was just he threw a jar at the pillar right in front of him, yeah. Walked around the jar, and then just got put right on his ass, so...
Yeah, our mimic tier...
Wasn't going well for the mimic tier.
Mimic tier isn't necessarily helpful. Like, this actually might be a fight where the soul jars are a good idea, just because they would explode.
Yeah, mimic tier is he's all brawn, no brains. He's big, he's handsome, he's like a golden retriever, big, beautiful, and dumb.
Oh fuck. okay, here's what we'll do. I will allow Jack to summon help. Thank you, Sir George Lucas. I mean, listen. Mm-hmm. Team ups. We've been utilizing team ups.
Yeah, that was an '80s. Like, all of those heroes had a little sidekick, had a little help, had a little.
I am not cross pollination of utilizing the team ups. Though I feel like before we do that, I do need to take out the tree sentinel.
Yes.
Because, well, I guess you know what? I could have someone help me with the tree sentinel too.
That is true.
Let's see if I can summon someone over here. Do I have the things? Oh, I do have the things. Okay. Yeah. All right. Let's summon some help. Let's end on a win. It's way more fun to end on a win.
And then on a win, Nick in the chat says, I hated this boss so much. Nick, did you hear the big news? Aragorn, it's coming. Disney Plus. Nick, you willed it into existence. Your love of Aragorn.
This guy has a pothead.
This can't be. This is...
This guy has a pothead and a crossbow. Is this someone in chat?
This is destiny.
Is this someone in chat who's going to come and help?
Impossible.
Hold on, we'll see. We'll see. I thought I summoned my pothead friend. Did I summon my pothead friend?
My pothead friend.
Where's my pothead friend?
You know what? Sometimes you think you summon your pothead friend, and sometimes they forgot.
Whoa.
Someone who has tried to summon their pothead friends.
Was that today? Dude. I really thought I hit the summon. Dude, I'm so sorry, dude. Well, I guess we'll summon this other friend who's here.
Nick, as when I said Nick that link, he immediately put it in our news Slack and said, we need to cover this, please, for me. I love this book series. What did I tell you, Nick? Number one Aragorn superfan.
Well, there you go.
I lost my mind in a similar matter when they said that the Duffer Brothers of the Hit Stranger Things were going to adapt The Talisman in the Black House from Stephen King. Those are his favorite books of mine, so I'm very excited about that.
Ooh, very nice.
Speaking of the Duffer Brothers, did you watch this season of Stranger Things?
I have not yet.
Okay, if I'm not mistaken, they introduce speaking of stoners as well, was this wrong? Oh, no, I'm right. So the stoner kid from the package, who I believe is the one who gets his penis cut off, right?
Okay.
Is it the stoner kid? Like the long-haired stoner kid?
Sure.
Sure. He plays he's one of the main characters of the season of Stranger Things. He plays a stoner pizza shop worker, pizza delivery man. I'm starting to think he's being typecast as a stoner, I'm going to be honest, guys.
You know... You get a type.
Yeah.
It's all fun and games until you can't get the roles you want.
Billy Wilbo says, is Jack part of the Escapist Elden Ring group? I'm gonna be honest. I didn't even know that was something.
I was just gonna ask, do we have an Elden Ring group? Because if we do, then yes.
Yeah.
But I don't think we have an official Elden Ring group. Also,
that's right, Andy, he played a stoner in season one of American Vandal.
Oh, I fucking love American Vandal.
That was good. So the team who did that just put out a new series, same format as American Vandal, but it's all about like an esports team.
Yeah.
And I don't want to watch a thing about esports, but everyone's like, it's just American Vandal, watch it. And so now I feel like I have to watch it.
Oh, well, then there you go.
And apparently it handles the video game stuff well, as opposed to a lot of stuff that does stuff about video games is pretty shitty.
I want to say I know that team because I believe American Vandal was a Funny or Die produced show.
That's a fun fact.
I believe I could very much be wrong.
Yeah, I don't know. I just remember it was on Netflix. Yeah. I don't know why I made weird like Vespa noises.
I like it that you made weird Vespa noises.
Yeah.
How about that?
Okay, that's good. So now it's worth it.
Oh, okay, great.
Yacenda and Parallo, who had previously worked together on short form videos for outlets such as Funny or Die or College Humor.
Oh, there you go.
Were joined by Schoner. So yeah, sounds like it. Look at that. Small world.
Whew. Okay, I think with the help of Yusurolo here, we're doing significant. I mean, we are doing significantly better. Whether we can keep that up for. I can't mimic tier?
No, can you not mimic tier when you have a human? The human is your mimic tier, I believe.
I thought I could. Oh, weird.
Yeah, I think when you have an NPC summon, you can mimic tier. If you have a human, you cannot.
Oh no, don't die, Yusul! Me, Malekith, me! Me! Explosions! Yusul, I need you!
Oh, jeez.
Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. Fuck. Don't die. Don't die me. Don't die me. Okay, here we go.
Don't die me!
Well, you know, you hate, like, you summon in someone and then you die, and then you're the dickhead, right?
Yeah, and then you feel like you need to, like, send them, edible arrangements to apologize.
Exactly. Whoa, that was close. What?
Rich Lucas says someone capable needs to make a Dark Tower show. Yeah. It's there. You just need to do it. You need to go whole hog, fully commit.
All the hogs.
Yeah, we need to go. We need just an abundance of hogs. They need to be like. They need to overestimate the amount of hogs.
Malekith, stay in one spot.
Swim Two Birds says this is wildly, solidly entertaining, and as Elden Ring goes. Given the classic status occurring, kind of works. Yeah, it's this challenge run. It works. It works. Did you do it, Jack?
No. But wait. We got so close. All right. Can we go longer? When's the next stream?
The next stream is at 6.
Okay, we're gonna give it one more shot.
We're gonna give it one more shot. This is up to you.
Give it one more.
Oh yeah, and Chad. Sorry, I should have mentioned that. So Hidden Gems has moved from Tuesday afternoons to Monday evenings because of Casey's new schedule at Ubisoft. Gotcha. And so Casey is going to be back with us in 40 minutes. Him and Jesse will be back playing. Stream is at 7 p.m. Central.
Oh, okay. So, yeah, we got a little extra time.
I don't think that's right, Nick. I might be wrong. There's a distinct possibility I'm wrong.
Yeah.
Because as someone who's been wrong a lot.
Yeah.
Nick, in the reviews channel this morning, Casey said, for confirmation, Jesse and I are doing Hidden Gems starting at 7 Eastern. Correct? And that got no reply from anyone. My reply was to the art request, which I made and sent. So I would ask Jesse and Casey what time it starts. I'm not sure what time it starts.
All right, we have Usul back, who's farting around, so he must be good. Usul hopefully knows what I'm doing. I don't know, Usul, if you are someone in chat or if you are just someone who's like, oh my God, I'm being summoned by the guy who's only using a crossbow again.
Oh yeah, Usul, if you're here, let us know.
Let us know.
Let us know, Usul.
All right, let's do this.
Chaotic Archon says, mutiny at the escapists. Who would have expected? This isn't a mutiny. I just want to make sure that our thing is scheduled at the right time. Also, because of, I want to make sure these are going to be the times I'm going to be on streams later this week, so I need to make sure.
Right? These are the important things to know.
yeah, everyone's saying when it starts on YouTube. It's all well and good when YouTube says it starts, because that's when Nick said it's going to start. What I'm saying is we need to figure out if Jesse and Casey know that.
Yeah.
So there needs to, YouTube needs to be speaking with Jesse and Casey. That's all that needs to happen. Right. You know what? We're going to fix it. This is how we work here. We get excited because Aragon is becoming a show, and then we're figuring out when streams are going to happen. So perfectly fine. Ooh, the man who chopped off the finger says Runark. Did you use a Runark? Do you have a Runark?
What's a Runark? Oh, fuck. I didn't use a Runark. I do have a Runark, though.
Okay.
Okay, can I? Okay, here we go. Runarked.
George Lucas says three streams a day is asking a lot. First off, George Lucas, how dare you? Second off, the streams, you don't need to watch all the streams. We want to give, maybe some people just want to see Yahtzee do goof. Maybe people want to see Jesse and Casey do a little bit of dabbling. Maybe people just like Hank's explosions.
Right.
Also, this is a big world. So a noon stream in the States doesn't work if you're in Australia. However, if you're working a 9-to-5, you can't watch any of our streams. All of a sudden, maybe we got these night streams. You get home, you pour a big glass of milk with your TV dinner. We got streams for you. Think about that. Must see TV. Billy Wibble is also asking if you drank the physics.
This time physics. I did. Yes. I drank the physic, and I did the. I have the crab. And refire power up. Oh, you still hold on.
Crab. Refire.
We're coming.
Nope. Storm Templar says, who drinks milk with dinners? People who are patriotic. Hank McFreedom. Meat Freedom? What is Hank? I think I just Irished him. Hank
just
Meat
Irished
Freedom
him,
drinks
but that's
milk
okay.
With
Hank. Oh no, did you still die?
Yusel
is so close to death. Oh fuck, and now I'm so close to death. Yusel might have died.
Oh, Yusel had big health.
The other like super sucky thing about Malekith is like his blade like forever lowers your health.
Yeah, if Yusel dies, can you mimic Tyr now?
Oh, that's a great question.
I don't know.
I cannot.
Okay.
Sorry, Yusel. I failed you.
Skeptical Wizard says, is it weird to drink milk straight from the cow? Absolutely not. It's as fresh as it can get. That's a first-hand source right there.
Yeah. That's how you want to drink it.
Yeah, they call that nature's water.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so yeah, it locks in, summons the whole fight. Thanks, Nick. I didn't know that.
Fuck.
Wraithbow says, I used to drink milk, now it tastes weird. Interesting.
I don't like milk.
Damn. Did you ever like milk?
Yeah. No. Actually, nope. You know what? Now that I think about it, no. Never a big milk.
Wraithbow says, milk's fine on cereal, but straight up it tastes weird. Dingus says, not spicy milk. I thought it was called spicy milk. I love spicy milk. Close. You did great.
We are so fucking close. It's utterly delicious. No, milk's super gross. Milk is sugar. That's all milk is. Milk is nothing but sugar, and I dislike it. And I dislike people who do like it. So there.
I don't think milk is what? Milk is sugar?
Yeah, milk. Like the calcium benefits have been incredibly overstated by the milk industry. Like milk is just sugar and fat. It is.
You're a big milk conspiracy theorist, aren't you?
There is very little actually healthy about milk.
Incredible.
All right, we gotta give this one more try. We are getting so fucking close. So
Chaotic Archon using membership, been a member for 18 months. Thank you so much. Using their comment to say, using my chat to tell Marty that he missed a comment. Incredible use. Incredible teamwork there, chat. And then got the Gripples. you got the Gripples. Is that like having the vapors?
Ooh, I got the Gripples.
I got the Gripples.
Ooh, Lordy, I got them Gripples.
Been a member for 9 months, which means that you are now the proud owner of an Escapist baby. That's what happens after 9 months, so congrats. Please take care of it. Says, my 12-year-old, I feel like this is just rubbing it in right now. My 12-year-old beat Malekith with no armor after watching me fail miserably. He's a gamer, but he hasn't played FromSoft games. It was a proud dad moment. That sounds, your kid is either a savant or there's some humdingery going on here.
Okay, so now the question, Marty.
Yeah.
Is there's Usul. Usul's here again.
Yeah, Usul the useful.
Usul, do I summon them for a third attempt?
I mean, they're going to keep coming?
And they're still here.
Also, Pride and Balls reminds you, Runark.
Runark, thank you. Runark now. Thank you. Runark now. Let's see if there's anyone else. Because, like, at this point, I feel bad that we keep losing.
Yeah.
You know, like, and it's, like, it's clearly my fault because I'm doing a goofy challenge run. If I don't see anyone else, I'm going to go Usul.
Nick, did we figure out what time the next stream is?
Yeah, that's another important question.
Sound off in the comments below.
Oh, here we go. We got someone new because I definitely feel... Oh, unable to summon Cooperator. Oh, well, fine. I didn't want to summon you. Unable to summon Cooperator. Well, then get the fucking summon sign out of there, you dick. All right. We need someone else. We need help. Hank Meat Freedom needs a team up. We need a team up.
The man who chopped off the finger says, craft. Don't forget the craft.
Oh, thank you.
I thought you were talking about the film, The Craft, which I think is a great... It's a great witch fiction.
Great witch fiction. I did craft. Thank you. Yep, I crafted. I rune arced. We're looking for a partner. I'm just out here. Like, I enjoy long walks on the broken pillars. And, you know, talking about pickles. If that sounds like it would be of interest to you, hit me up on Klondike 3755.
People in chat are, including Nick the OG, are offering help. Well, can they only help if they're on the same platform as you? And what platform are you on?
I'm on PC, and I'm here, and I've gold finger. If you're here, I'm here. I'm waiting.
Finger. So it's PC only. So Nick's help was from a PS5.
Oh, I apologize.
Katak Archon says, "Did you touch the summon icon?
Do I have to? I mean, I've been summoning people."
Did you touch it every time, though?
Do you have to?
I'm going to stop talking about touching it. I don't know what's happening. I don't know.
The summoning pool is now functional. Oh, you know what? I didn't touch it before. Okay. Well, then there you go. So now do I need to do the thing? Oh, cancel. Okay. Apparently, I didn't do it before. But then
using
how was
the
I
summon
able to...
pool statue increases chances of finding people.
Oh, there you go. Okay.
It isn't necessary, but is it necessary to summon signs you can already see?
Oh, beautiful.
I don't know. I did very little summoning in the game. That wasn't like a humble brag. It's just I get nervous when I see other people.
Well, you know,
it was my thing of like, I don't want to fail them.
That's a very Midwestern thing of just like,
yeah.
Oh, I'm not pulling my weight.
Yeah,
I know
I'm literally doing this because I can't pull the weight myself.
Right, I know I asked you for help, but now I have to do extra work to show you that I don't need that much help.
Nico Munka says, is Jack using a password? We're not using a password because we're summoning randos.
Yeah, anyone.
Like, I don't know if anyone here.
And I know, like, if you use a password, then, like, you can theoretically summon the people whom you want to, but I just need help. Oh, wait, now there's someone. Ooh, there's a couple someones. Okay, who's here?
Oh, you got to choose?
Usul. Oh, Usul's back. Oh, what do we do?
It would be really nice if we could close this out with Usul.
I mean, we gotta give it a shot then.
Nico Monka says, oh, it's a Midwestern thing. That explains a few things. Yeah, if there's a weird thing that both Jack and I do, it's you could probably toss it up to like, oh, they were raised in a weird place.
Yeah. Hi again.
Hey.
All right.
Is that a human voice or is that a machine man?
Yeah, that's a human. Hey, you know, when you get to choose a voice and you when you use your emotes, your guy says something. Hey.
Oh, but that wasn't that man's voice.
Yeah, he says it too. You hear his voice.
No, was he like speaking out of his speaker?
No,
like,
no, no.
Are
no,
you
no,
hearing?
I heard his NPC voice.
Gotcha. All
right.
I don't know how video games work, guys.
All right, here we go. Here we go, here we go. Physic. Crab.
Physic crab.
And go. I'm going to save my fire for when we get inside. Now I'm going to fire.
Man who chopped off figure says prawn, golden vow.
Oh, I could golden vow too. I did prawn.
Fuck. George Lucas says Jack and Marty are united by the Mars Cheese Castle. Truly, yeah. That is our totem in life.
Our totem, yes.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck. We got to phase one, or phase two, real dang fast. Oh, okay.
Now, that happened crazy fast.
Yeah. I think Yusel maybe now knows, like, oh, the person I'm with is an idiot.
Gotcha.
Which I'm very okay with them thinking that, because that just helps me.
Nick said, all right, let's assume that they're going to start at 7 Eastern, so that is a half an hour from now. But next time will be 7 Central. Okay, so tonight, their stream is a half an hour from now. And then Dad is telling us this is our last attempt so they can set up the next stream.
Fair.
So Dad's telling us we only get one more game before bed. Also, Nick said we have to go to bed after this, which is crazy because like I'm an adult and he's not in my state and he can't tell me when to go to bed. T900 says, looks like Usul's back on the menu, boys. That's great. That's a great callback. Was that this stream? No, that was the last stream. That's the callback to the last stream. We were talking about meat's back on the menu, boys, which is a very, very strange line.
It's a very, very strange line because it assumes that orc culture has restaurants.
Yeah, which just doesn't make any sense.
Which doesn't make any sense. All right. Well, we're going to pick it up from here. So next explosion-only stream, we know what we have to do. We need help. We need friends. We're going to leave that there because, yeah, or else it's just going to be versus Malekith all night, and it's gonna suck.
Also, if you are a PC player and you think you have a build that can help Jack out, maybe be ready a week from now. Because we might call you in for assistance.
Oh, we will 100% call you in for assistance.
Yeah,
we need,
yeah, absolutely.
We need help, but once we get through Malekith, it's just boss rush time, and I think we can beat the game next stream, because then it's just Malekith.
The dude who turns into Horaloo and
then Elden Beast.
Yeah.
So we are close. We are devastatingly close to winning here.
Yeah, it's incredible. Nick says, make sure to get your milk from the source before bed, you dummies. So I guess we got to do that. We got to go straight to the teat.
Leaving out the milk. Ew.
Yes, and remember, chat, come back in half an hour. Casey and Jesse will be back with Crosscode with Hidden Gems at the new Hidden Gems time. And then tune in tomorrow at noon. Nick and I will be, or Nick and someone will be back for the editor's hour. Are we already done?
No, I undid it because you started saying
sorry,
stuff, so I unbied.
Sorry. No,
I was,
no,
I was ready to, I was ready to
be
say
good
goodbye.
To each other, and Monday Night Football comes back in September, so get excited for that.
Bam, bada, bam, bam, bada, bam, 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 bam.